sway.
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 In the morning.
In the morning.
In the morning.
Don't shake your body.
Wake your punk ass up. Then.
Crust out your eyes.
Passport, Junior Reed is here. That's from the album Junior Reed Living Legend?
Yeah, that's from the album Legend. Living Legend.
When is the album out?
Well, we plan to bring it for the Christmas, you know?
For Christmas?
Yeah.
Mm. You know, Damn, man, how can we? Jamaica is such a interesting place that has so much history attached to it that people don't even realize, and a lot of people may not even understand. Number one, the catalyst to hip hop,
right,
music, came from Jamaica.
Right.
Okay, if you think about Kool Herc and his origins.
Right.
And we could trace it back to those drums in Africa, how people communicated through the rhythms.
The drum, right?
Yeah, through the rhythms. Right. And then a lot of people, for example, you know, my Rastas in my family, that's where my locks, when I locked up, that's where it came from. And people have so many misconceptions about what it is to be Rasta.
Yeah.
And then other folks might, you know, it's different sects, you know, different levels to it. And other folks may see it different ways. What is it for you?
Well, for me, you know, being a Rasta, it's just, you have to just know, so well, it's all about love, you know.
Mm-hmm.
First, I put love, because Jah is love. You know, the Father who we praise to, him have all of the love. So, you don't matter, you know, if he's a ballad man out there or whatever, as long as, if you call up on the Father in a different name, the Father don't feel no way about that because him create all names. You understand me?
Mm-hmm.
So being a Rasta is just a natural way of living. You know, eat natural like you don't snow so well. You know, you be like the tree that planted by the rivers of water. You understand me? You eat natural. You know, you eat vegetables and them thing and natural food.
Mm-hmm.
You don't eat the deaders.
Mm-hmm.
Because when you eat up the dead as you turn yourself in a human graveyard, you know.
Yeah.
Same way like how the funeral home bury them dead and them keep them dead on ice. You put your chicken on fridge and then you dress it up, you bury it down in your system and then, you know, you start to have that spirit inside that you have chicken spirit, hog spirit, all kind of spirit.
Mm-hmm.
So true Rasta no deal them kind of spirit, Rasta just stay upon a natural thing where we just live off of, you know, just vegetable and vegetarian.
Mm-hmm.
And at the same time too, we just have love and we just care for each other, you know, we just care for everyone like how we care for ourselves. You understand me?
Mm-hmm.
And also, well, I just want, so. That's Rastafari that to me, because Jah is love.
Right.
You understand me?
That's what I was, growing up, I was taught if you eat meat, you turn your body into a coffin.
Right, right.
And that's why, I mean, devout Rastas don't eat meat. Now, I was eating a lot of meat, though.
but at the same time, you know, what you eat don't defile you still, you know.
Yeah.
It's your works, you know. You understand
me? Mm-hmm.
So a man may eat certain things out there, but that don't stop him from being a Rasta.
Yeah.
But it take a while to come around.
Mm-hmm.
Because this is the God is a free God, you know. The God don't force nobody to say, stop eat meat and come and be Rasta.
Right. Mm-hmm.
Him law you, make you go and eat the meat where you eat. But when you see the God, he might eat something natural and he might eat something. So every time you see the guy and he might drink a roots and he might drink a beer, you're going to start to say, we're going to try where the God are drinking, you know, try the roots. And when you try the roots and drink that and you love it naturally, after a while, no, you don't even want the beer and it's not the God tell you to stop drinking, you just stop drinking the beer off of your own.
Mm-hmm.
So after a while, you're not going to go back to it because you just get rid of it off of your own. But if it's somebody force you and say, being a Rasta, being this, or stop, do this and stop that, after a while, if that person come out of your life, you're going to go back and do the same thing.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
You understand? So the God is a patient God, and him love everyone. You understand me? For us, take them time and come right around. You understand me?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
It's a work in progress.
Right.
Your locks, because I don't call it dreadlocks.
Right.
I never got into that. I just, the word dread for me is so derogatory. So I just say your locks.
Yeah.
People don't understand, you know, when my locks, I grew for 17 years until my father passed away and something, the covenant is in the heart. So it made me want to, because we let go of his.
Right.
I'm going to recrown in a second, though.
Right.
The locks, what do the locks mean to you? What do they stand for?
Well, you know, when you wear the locks, it's a Nazarene vow, you know, you understand me? It shows so well, right? I know, you know, you're back from the creation, you understand me? It's like you present yourself the way how God created you, because at the same time, God never created you. He created you with the ear and everything and so on. So him never created for you really trim it off or whatever. So what is just man do them thing and whatever. So you understand me? So your locks, you know, as you say, is your strength.
Mm-hmm.
Because see when them say Samson, when them trim Samson get weak and them thing there.
Mm-hmm.
You know, well, a man locks I'm strength because, you know, spiritually and physically.
Mm-hmm.
Cause like your antenna. Mm-hmm. It pick up good vibes and it can pick up bad vibes based upon your meditation.
Mm.
You understand
true,
me?
Yeah. That's true. So, they're like antennas.
It's like your antennas.
Yeah. You know, you walk in a room, I can feel it, you right. know, because right. What I always say this, you know, I feel energy wherever I go.
Right.
Especially working in the snake pit called right. the music business. Right. I call it the snake pit. The
snake pit.
You know, right. but we forced to deal with the snake. So, yeah. but a lot of times when I go in the room, I stand in a corner. So right. I could corner all the energy. When you saw me last night, Tracy G, where was I?
In the corner.
In the corner. So I could catch all of the energy. Junior Reed is hanging out with us.
Yes.
Turn his mic on.
Woo!
I got to catch this. We got the legend here live in the studio.
Yes.
Run that from the top. Can you join the song?
You want me to join it?
Blood. You could have come from Rima, or you come from jungle. Could have come from Firehouse, or you come from Tower Hill. One blood. You could have come from Libya, or you come from America. Could have come from Europe, or you come from Africa. One blood. You could have been an Irishman or an Englishman. Could have been a Mexican or a with an Indian. One blood. Hey, mate, why? I want you to get me straight. Cooperate, yeah. Hey, mate, I want you to get me straight. Blood. Hey, God, do you believe in love? Hey, blow. This is no joke. You could have been a soldier man, or a policeman, or a civilian. Say the whole of we are
one blood. Junior Reed.
Say Sivenite Cuba, Ovenite Panama, Sivenite Haiti, Ovenite Italy. Una sangre. Companiera. Kira que sea sincera. Wahoy, stand your high, companiera. Wahoy, Kira que sea sincera. Standing by, wahoy. Say Sivenite. Man.
Wow. The album is called Legend, Living Legend.
Yeah, Junior Reed, Living Legend.
He's sitting with us, Sway in the Morning, Shade 4-5. We got a lot of people on the lines, man. Let's take a few calls. A few calls real quick. We got Nico. Is it Rico from D.C.?
Rico, Tennessee.
What's up, man? Say hello to Junior Reed.
What's up, my man?
Listen, my brother.
Respect to Jamaica, man.
Yeah, man. Jamaica, man.
I just had a couple of questions. If Bob Marley and, by any chance, Marcus Garvey playing any influence on any of your music?
Bob Marley. Yeah, well, you know, we all get inspiration from, you know, each other. We get inspiration from Marcus Garvey. We get inspiration from Bob Marley. We get inspiration from Hugh Mundell, Dennis Brown. You name it. You know, a lot of artists out there. You understand me?
No doubt. A lot of music.
All right. Speak the Truth was about
you. Speak the Truth. That's my first song.
Yeah, first
produced
song.
Produced by Hugh Mundell.
Yeah. Hugh Mundell. Can you explain to who Hugh Mundell was?
Hugh Mundell, you know, for me, he was a producer for me and also my favorite artist.
Mm-hmm.
You understand me? One of the greatest vocalists in the world, writer and everything, and producer. You know, Hugh Mundell. You know, first hit song was Africa Must Be Free at the age of 18. Then he started to produce me by the age of, I was the age of 16 when Hugh Mundell take me in the studio.
Mm-hmm.
No, 14. And the song released when I was 16.
Mm-hmm.
And Hugh Mundell is one of the great out of reggae music, you know, one of the great youth. And, you know, Hugh Mundell is everything to the business. So when the business lose all the youth like Hugh Mundell, you know, it's a big loss. For the industry, you understand me?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, because you have kids right now and people right now that is buying you Mondale song and don't know that he passed away and think he's a new artist just come.
Yeah.
And he's a fresh artist because his song's still relevant.
Mm-hmm.
And it's over 20 odd years you Mondale die. You understand me? And so you know that he's a great youth, you know?
Yeah, and look it up. If you don't know, look him up. Google him.
Trace you Mondale.
I will.
Yep.
Are you familiar with Snoop Lion?
Yeah, Snoop Lion.
Okay, so when you initially heard that when he was Snoop Dogg and he wanted to transition and really enthrall himself in Rastafarian culture, were you welcoming it or were you skeptical at first?
I have to welcome. I'm so happy about it. I welcome Snoop Dogg because, you know, Snoop Dogg, all right, you see, Haile Selassie, he have a little dog, you know, and more time he turned into a lion.
Mm-hmm.
So, long time Snoop Dogg is a lion, see me, you understand me? Mm-hmm. I'm just ready to bring out the lion out of him. So I give thanks to Snoop Dogg because when Snoop Dogg come into reggae, him only embrace reggae more. And all of Snoop Dogg fans who never know about reggae will go and listen to reggae and tune into reggae. So, you know, and it's one family because we say one blood, we all have to sing the same song. There's going to be a day when we all have to sing the same song. So when Snoop Dogg come to reggae and him embrace it,
mm-hmm.
and we have to love Snoop Dogg for that.
He got some backlash, though.
Yeah, because you have some haters in the business.
Okay. Yeah.
So you have some haters. If Snoop Dogg come to Jamaica and never come to them,
mm-hmm.
they hate on that.
Mm-hmm.
You understand me? But it's bigger than those hating things. You understand
me?
Yes. Yeah.
You spoke about Snoop going to Jamaica. So many of us have been to Jamaica, beautiful country, vacation there, travel there. And then when you get there, you want to travel and see the different places, and people will tell you, no, you can't go to this part. Are things getting better in certain areas?
Look here. You see, all right, there's a system set in Jamaica. You see, the guys in the country, the investor, they set up a lot of hotels in the country,
mm-hmm.
in the countryside. So they want the tourists to stay down in the country. They want, when you come to Jamaica, they just pick you up into one of them, rent a bus or rent a car.
Yeah.
Take you straight to the all-inclusive.
Mm-hmm.
Everything is in there. You get live music in there. You get food. You get everything. You don't see the outside world. You don't know. You don't get no experience of what is really
right. mm-hmm.
Jamaica. You understand me? And then when I'm done with you, they just take you back on the bus and put you on the plane. And you go, but you see, if you come to Jamaica and you don't come to Kingston, you don't come to Jamaica. Because you have to come to Kingston to see the real Jamaica.
Yeah.
And Kingston is not as bad as how they make it look because sometimes some terrible thing happening in the country, but they don't put it in the paper because of them tourists. They don't want to mess up them tourist mm-hmm. industry.
Mm-hmm.
So sometimes the wickedest thing happening in the country, but they just keep it on the download and tourists keep going around and think everything all right and it's not all right.
Mm-hmm.
So at the same time, you know, anywhere in the world you go,
mm-hmm.
it's just how you move and how you live and who you know and where you go. And you understand me?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, so we'll Kingston... see. It's one of the safest places for me.
Yeah.
And then, see, down in the country, it's getting more, because, yeah, man, you know, the most gun is in the country, in mm-hmm. Jamaica, and they make it look like it's Kingston.
Mm-hmm.
It's not mm-hmm. Kingston.
It's not Kingston. And plus...
So, all my people, when you come to Jamaica, check out Kingston, because you see, true, a lot of hotels is not in Kingston. Maybe a few, all right. A few hotels in Kingston, and they have more hotels in the country. So they want to keep the tourism down in the country, so them tell them, so when you come to Jamaica, don't go to Kingston. Don't go there. Just come down in the country. Come to Negril, Otres, Montego Bay.
Mm-hmm.
And Ray, when you go there, you don't see Jamaica.
And tell them you know Junior Reed, you get a pass.
You'll yeah, right. That's all right.
All right, we'll take one more call. We got Dennis in Florida. Go ahead, Dennis. Say hello to Junior Reed.
Hey, good morning, Junior.
Yeah, blessed love, my Lord.
Good morning, guys.
Good morning.
Junior, I tried following your career from way back. And I remember one of the first songs you did was one called... The Babylon remove the chain.
Babylon release the chain and I use them brains.
Right. How your time that you spent with Black Uhuru.
Yeah.
What did you learn from from that group?
Well, I learned from that group. I learned about the politics of the music, you know, and I learned, you know, about, you know, being out there because my first big international tour. No, my second international tour was with me and Black Uhuru. Before I went on tour with Sugar Mine at Don Carlos. And then after that, while I was on tour, I heard that Black Uhuru need a lead singer. And I saw posters all over where I was touring. And when I get back to Jamaica, I find out that it's me, Simon, have to go and do those shows.
Mm-hmm.
That was promoted, you understand me, in a second. And when we learn from Black Uhuru, you know, as we say, the politics of the business, and know the business, and know about the snakes in the business, mm-hmm. know the kind of game, and have some good experience at the same time, like going to the Grammy Award for my first time and meeting all the stars them in the same room with all the big stars them, so that you make me know so well, he's One Blood, that you help motivate to sing a song like One Blood, because mm-hmm. I used to see these stars on TV
yeah.
and say, oh man, I can't wait to meet this star. When we meet them now, it's just one people, and the same way, oh, I meet them, you know, I'm happy for meet them. It's the same way them excited for meet me too.
Yeah,
so
yeah.
It's One Blood.
Junior Reed is here, living legend. Junior Reed, it's the name of the album. Look for it in December. We're going to play Gundam Load in a moment, but man, since I got you here, man, I can't let you go without throwing on some beats and you know, some rhythms and just letting you just vamp on that. Is that okay?
Yeah, man, I'm ready, man. Yeah.
Say, John, la, la.
Okay. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
All right.
If you get on this one, man, I'm a faint.
Get on.
One Blood Junior Reed. Bitch, I'm singing at the business and them can't cut me speed. Them call me One Blood Junior Reed. If you see me in a one group, yes, I meet them giddy lead. Them call me One Blood Junior Reed. Bitch, I'm singing at the business and them can't cut me speed. Them call me One Blood Junior Reed. If you see me in a one group, yes, I... Although them see me uptown and firehouse me come from, I go lift out me foundation. Struggling at the ghetto as a young musician. Work hard in at the business, make a lot of hit song. Fix up in a Europe and then ban me Uncle Sam out there at the airport for greet me. No whole heap of me fans. Lose the port of flat, me ask me a lot of question. Una beg me autograph and come hold on for me. And them call me One Blood Junior Reed. Bitch and sing on at the business and they can't cut me speed. They call me One Blood Junior Reed. Bitch and sing, yeah. After me fix up the world with one blood and foreign mind, Babylon a on me dung, but the bobo had fi fine. They give me contract when them know me na go sign. When I try it one away with Rastafari on me mind. One Blood Junior Reed. Bitch, I sing out of the business and they can't cut me speed.
One Blood Junior
Reed. I don't want to feel out of the ganja man. See, all ganja man. Here the one. Say, John, la, la, what are you charging me for? Him say, where you get them your high-grade ganja? Me tell him, prescribed by the doctor. Herb and I don't know where man fi charge for. One of them I say that are the good Alaska. Next one I say that are the Cambodia. One of them I say that are the good Indica. Next one I call it Sensemina. One of them I call it marijuana. Next one I turn on I call it ganja. Say One Blood family smoke at the herb till we eyes them a bleed. Bust a rhyme, wake up and smoke a fat bag of weed. Him say One Blood, everybody like June, I read him. Say yeah, take another draw and say yeah, yeah, yeah. When him kiss, man.
DJ Wonder. How you like that, Junior Reed? The legend, the legend. You catch this one?
You want this one again?
Yeah, 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 yeah.
All fruits, yo. All fruits ripe, shake the grape tree. A grape is there for you and me. All fruits ripe, shake the grape tree. A grape is there for you and me. No call me no Dan, no call me name brand. Call me Mr. Man, wahoy. No call me no Dan, no call me name brand. Call me Mr. Man. Say name brand, get brand, and have a dusty Dan. Call me Mr. Man, wahoy. Say Dan have a dusty Dan, name brand, get brand. Call me Mr. Man. He say all fruits ripe, shake the grape tree. A grape is there for you when me get your palm more. Nobody make your land get push up. And you don't wanna tell him say no call me. Say no call me no banana boat man. Banana boat man. Tell him say no call me. Say no call me no banana boat man. Banana boat man. Come and say oh John Richard Farin him no one no passport. Never travel to no man man the airport. Leave down at the one poor man airport. Oh, him leave out pan a banana boat. Now them are on things.
Yes, yes. Do your read, do your read. Rewind.
I like it. You know something? It's just because I just wake up in the morning, kind of a awesome voice, like a little bass.
Yes.
So, you know.
And get you lifted, but, right? Yeah.
Sound nice.
Yeah. I like that. Junior Reed, thank you for coming by, man.
Yes.
It's a pleasure,
living
man.
Legend, Junior Reed.
Yeah.
Look for that album in December.
Yeah. It's a Christmas treat.
It's a Christmas treat. Make sure you pick it up and support this man. He's a living legend.
Yes.
Come back anytime.
Yeah, man. Definitely, my brother. Love.
Absolutely. It's a new single. Gundam Load. Load. Yeah, who's on it?
Huh? It's Uncle Vibes Cartel, Uncle Murder, and myself. And you see, as you say, there was a drumming. Well, I'm bringing back the drum in now because mm-hmm. we have to start communicating through the drum.
Yes.
And this is an experiment I'm doing right now. You can hear a little bit of reggae in it. You hear a little hip-hop.
Mm-hmm.
You understand me? And you hear reggae, hip-hop, and the Naya Bingi order, the 1-2 mm-hmm. Naya Bingi order.
Excuse me, you got to explain now.
Everything you talk, I got it here, man. Okay. Everything you say, I got it right here.
But you got it right there in the music. Talk about the Naya Bingi order. Talk about that.
Well, you see, the Naya Bingi order is an order where, you know, from Jamaica, I and I as Rasta gather and play the drums, you know, to keep the original tradition vibes. You understand me? Because how we used to communicate with the drum in Africa, whenever you used to write no letter, we just beat the drum here.
Mm-hmm.
And the next one was Zoe to beat it, and the next one, Ghana beat it and go right around. And so, well, all right. You see, the drumming now, is it mean death to all oppressor.
Mm-hmm.
You understand me?
Mm-hmm.
And you see, the funde, all right, the repeater mm-hmm. is a lightning. You understand me? And the funde is earthquake.
Mm-hmm.
And the bass drum is thunder, you boom.
Yeah.
Thunder, you understand me?
Mm-hmm.
And the shaker shake them out and them thing there. So, you know, we are get back to the self, you understand
mm-hmm.
me? Because you see the drumming, that is what them hide out of the music.
Mm-hmm.
Because we used to use it, and that's our real tool. Mm-hmm. So if we bring forth that right now, and that will calm the youths and make them stop kill off them one another.
Yeah.
And make them stop disrespect
mm-hmm.
the woman them. Because if you notice, when you listen to this Cartel song, when I send when Cartel get this beat here, right? Him know where him have to put on it. Me have to tell him, say,
mm-hmm.
sing positive thing or anything at all. When him hear it, him get that energy there and him just come out with it. So this song that me as Cartel even Panita tell us, King Selassie is the only way.
Mm-hmm.
You understand mm-hmm. me? And we have to, you know, Marcus Garvey, the youth them for read. It's not like him tell him say this, that, and drop your pants and bleach out. I will change them thing there.
Yeah.
You understand me? So right now, this music, you know, you can just know say this is a part of the change.
Mm-hmm.
It's a part of the new.
So youth are still bleaching their skin in Jamaica? They still doing it?
Well, not as much as how they used to do it before.
Okay. Mm.
You understand me?
Yeah, I didn't
get
that.
And know that Cartel is a man now dealing with reality and I sing some positive song for the youth them too. Because he inspire a lot of youth and a lot of youth look up to him. So, you know, so well. From a Rastafari, I must say all of the youth have to come to Rastafari because Rastafari is the only way.
Mm-hmm.
You understand me?
Mm-hmm.
And Rastafari is us. You understand me? Because God, Emmanuel, the Almighty God, you know, 3 in 1, 1 in 3,
mm-hmm.
earth, sky, and sea. Yeah, well, Emmanuel mean God is with us.
Mm-hmm.
So when I come here, so you speak gods and goddess in the room right here. So we have to start see God through one another. We can't, I look out of space and see God and think, say, Jesus is going to fly come down with wings.
Mm-hmm.
Or Haile Selassie is going to ride upon our ass come. Haile Selassie is here. And if it's Jesus is saying, Jesus is here then. You understand me?
Mm-hmm.
Because every day, when you see life, a God is it, and everything you want from God, you go and get it through a man or a woman or your mother, your father, your sister, your brother. You never from you know yourself and you're small till now, and every day you say, God know I want this. God know I need some money. God know I need some food.
Mm-hmm.
If somebody bring it, come give you.
Mm-hmm.
So God move through that person. But when that person come and give you what he asks God for, you forget, say, it's God, he asks it and say, oh, I'm lucky, and give the person lucky.
Right.
Yeah. And you don't know who is lucky if lucky is the devil.
Right. Yeah.
So you have to remember back yourself and say, you know, say, God know me, say, I want some money to go set up a house or set up a business. And then this lady just come and she just give me my money. So you instead of you say, look, you just know, so you say, bless the Lord, my Lord.
Mm-hmm.
Give thanks, my Lord, because of my Lord, you ask, and he move through your temple and come and assist me. Because
right.
You see, the God now, we is the instrument of the God.
Mm-hmm.
And you see, the God run the whole world, and him love all of us. You understand me? I don't want to leave out none of us. So, you see, if a Chinese man in China wants something and an Indian man in India wants something and a black man and so on and a white man and so on, the God can't run around at the same time attend to everybody and feed them.
Yeah.
So, he must sit up on him throne and move through every living flesh all right
mm-hmm.
and accomplish what you want and accomplish what the Chinese man accomplish and just stay so. So, that's, and then I see him, you know, the devil up on him throne
mm-hmm.
in a room now where he do peer rungs and I move through the flesh of certain people. So, every day, there's God and the devil out there in the street. So I guess you have to keep the God in you. And at the same time, although the devil finds himself in a man, a man still, you know, no matter what man evil us, him still can't change. Mm-hmm. Cause God are the greatest.
Yes.
And God are the creator. So, look, yes. Here a man, Steve, can still come forward around, you know. So, yes. We are the gods and the goddess. And them tell us, say, a man is just a man.
Yeah.
Because why them tell a man is just a man? Because they want, when they do a man something, mm-hmm. if you kill a man, they say, oh, that's nothing. He's just a man.
Mm-hmm.
But if they tell us, say, a man, a God in a man, and them tell us, we fear God, you don't fear a man. Mm-hmm. Some man will sleep with all him door open. You're not going to go do him nothing because you're saying, at God that's asleep, you know.
Because
mm-hmm. the whole of we is gods and goddess, but they don't tell us that.
Right.
You understand me?
Rastafari. Junior Reed, ladies and gentlemen. Yeah, I love that. We're going to play this back over and over and over again. All right, on Shade 405, it's Gun Them Load. Look for the project in December. Brethren, thank you for coming through.
It's a pleasure, man. Pleasure. When I come and I see you, you don't know the energy you give me. You understand me?
Yes.
Yeah, man. And I was even saying to my publicist when I was coming, say, that's my brethren right there. When I saw your picture down there.
Yeah, you saw the picture?
Yeah.
They got the picture in the hallway, by the way.
Stun on them.
This is my brethren. You give me the same energy.
Right.
We bumped into each other in Oakland.
Right.
Randomly.
Random.
No cameras, no mic.
Not just on a download.
I'm walking by myself in Oakland.
All
right. You know, and I see Junior Reed, and we stop and we start building.
Right.
Organically.
Yeah, man, I can't forget that day, man.
Yeah.
God,
you see, I remember the roots.
Yes.
The Baba roots.
You remember the Baba roots.
It's Sway in the Morning, only on Shade 45.